What are you thinking now? You're thinking very deeply, mate.
I don't know, I'm just thinking, like, do we just... I feel like Loki is... You don't even, like, play Gibby. Crypto's gonna be, like, meta, so hard meta.
What's up, guys, and welcome to Robert Squad. If you're new here, hi, hello, bonjour, my name's Bress, and I make Apex Legends videos. So this is the Crypto 2.0 video that I've been teasing, and I'll go over the changes that Crypto received and teach you guys things that you can do to get the most out of his kit. There's also timestamps in the video, so you can skip to whatever section of the video that you're most interested in. In the first section, we'll go over the changes that he got. Then in the second section, I'll give you all the tips to becoming a GOAT crypto main and share my secrets. Then we'll wrap it up. As you heard from Hal, Sweet, and Jen in the intro, Crypto is actually an insane character now. I think he's easily in A rank, and even the developers said it in the patch notes. He's always been a solid pick, but he's hard to play and master, and that pushes players away. Starting with his buffs, the drone view HUD is improved. They made the UI much smoother when you're in the drone, and you can see things that are going on in the match, like ring information, your minimap, the kill feed, and also the survey beacons. Previously, you had to constantly open your map while you're in the drone whenever you want to scan a beacon and don't know its specific location, and it was so much pain. They also increased the scan radius from 160 to 240, and some people think that this isn't a big deal, but if you do the math, that's a 50% increase in scan radius. The scan radius is so wide now, and so is the EMP radius. Now it's much easier for you to destroy the caustic traps, the Watson traps, and EMP those annoying caustic mains. What do I think of the changes? I think Crypto was a solid legend already, and the buffs were needed to make him more accessible and easier to play. I've seen some say he still needs an off-the-grid passive, but I really don't agree. Crypto is really strong. The only problem is that all his abilities are centered around his drone, which can be countered by only 5 bullets. No other legend is like that. That's why you should learn when and how to use the drone. It's very important, and we'll come to that in the later section of this video, so stick around for that. The pros of this buff is that Crypto will definitely become more popular, especially in high level ranked and competitive Apex. Like, if most of the teams have a Crypto in their team, then Gibby will be useless, cause Crypto will easily counter those late game Gibby bubbles, and not forgetting that his EMP radius is increased by 50% now. The only con of these changes is that now Crypto has a higher chance of getting taken in the select screen. Yo, bro, can I please have Crypto?
No!
Bro, can I please have... Fucking hell, man. And this is even before his heirloom releases. He'll probably have the coolest heirloom in the game so far, and I'm very excited about that. The only other con I can think about is that with the tactical button changes, my muscle memory as a Crypto main is a bit messed up, and I find myself struggling to enter the drone view sometimes when I need to. But that's not even an issue, it just takes time. Overall, I really like the changes that Crypto got. I want to kiss the Respawn devs that came up with these Crypto buffs, cause in my opinion, Crypto, Caustic, Mirage, and Bangalore are the most difficult legends to rework their abilities without making them overly oppressive. I'm happy the devs did a good job on him, and he won't have to be nerfed in the future. Good, now for the next section, I'll give you some tips to help you learn how to play Crypto much faster and much better. First tip, use your drone to bait your enemies in gunfights. Since Crypto can throw out his drone now, when you're in a gunfight, just throw the drone at the side of the enemy. When you do this, most people focus on the drone, and you can use this opportunity to rush them and kill them easily while they're busy shooting the drone. This works so well because so many players are used to shoot down the drone as soon as they see that they're getting scanned. Just do this when there's a piece of cover in front of you, as there's a short animation while throwing the drone, it's not instant. So if you're not careful, it might backfire on you. And if you're on the receiving end, when an enemy Crypto throws his drone mid-fight, read the situation. If you can shoot down the drone instantly, then do it quick. Otherwise, focus on the enemy Crypto. Second tip is that when you're holding down a building in ranked or the new control LTM, use the drone to guard and watch over multiple entrances. If you're watching one door, throw the drone to the other door that's not in your line of sight. And once you get used to using the drone, you can do this much more efficiently by constantly switching from door to door. Watch one door for a while, then throw the drone to the other door that's not in your line of sight. Then after some time, recall the drone and then start watching the other door. And then throw the drone to the door that you were previously watching. I hope that was not as confusing as it sounded in my head. But yeah, when you throw the drone, make sure to throw it upwards and in corners, because it will automatically center itself like a CCTV camera. And this way, the enemy will have a harder time shooting it down. Next tip, when you press your tactical button, the drone flies on autopilot for some distance, 25 meters I think, but when you press and hold, you enter the drone view immediately when you deploy it, but it doesn't fly forward, it stays in the same position. So when you press and hold to enter the drone, hold W or push the analog stick forward so that you can save time and start flying forward immediately when you enter drone view. Also, because it flies forward when you throw it, you can throw it whenever you enter a building so it can scan for traps and enemies that may be rotting. Fourth tip, remember to actively recall your drone after deploying it because it has lesser HP now, so it can easily get destroyed. And sometimes you forget that you already threw it out, then when you try throwing it again, you'll accidentally get into the drone, which can lead you to getting sent back to the lobby. My last tip for you is to get used to running behind once you throw out the drone. If you want to EMP an enemy and not get affected by your own EMP, because the drone moves forward when you deploy it, and when you move back, it means that you'll be increasing the distance between you and the drone, so you can avoid EMPing yourself. Though sometimes self-EMP may be viable. For example, if the enemy has broken your shields already and you haven't broke theirs, throw the drone upwards, then try to start batting up before the EMP hits, so that when the EMP goes off, you'll have finished batting up, then the tables will be turned, you'll have more shields than the enemy. Those were the 5 tips I came up with for playing the new buffed crypto. There's obviously more tips. I've already done a couple of crypto tip videos before. I remember I did one for BR, Battle Royale, and another one for you, Arena Warlords. I'll link both videos in the description. You should definitely watch them if you plan on maining crypto or just want to not suck at playing crypto. And a bonus tip is that right now you can throw Mad Magi's tactical on a teammate's drone and he can fly towards enemies and burn them. It's a fun glitch that should and will definitely get patched, but be careful using this. It's very possible to get banned if a bunch of people report you, like how Taxi was permanently banned for using the caustic speed glitch in ranked. So I recommend only doing this once or twice just for laughs, cause it's really funny and it reminds me of the season 6 crypto rampant bug. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Please leave the video a like if you enjoyed it. It will help me get back into the YouTube algorithm, because I took a 6-month break and now YouTube is punishing me for that. And let me know in the comments if I left out any important tip that you might have, because sharing is caring. So share your tips and knowledge with the rest of us. And lastly, if you're new, consider subscribing and turning on post notifications so you never miss any future upload. I hope you have a lovely day and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.